Hello and welcome to the lecture session. In today's video, I am going to do the tutorial 1 in the module 4. In this tutorial, what are the problems I have discussed, more number of problems will be said. Coming to the Taylor series method, using Taylor series method, find y at x is equals to 0.1, 0.2. Considering up to 4th degree terms, given that dy by dx is x square y minus 1 and y of 0 is 1 is the initial condition. So here it is given that x naught is 0 and y naught is 1, y dash is x square y minus 1, then the Taylor series up to the 4th degree is given by the formula y of x is equal to y naught y of x naught plus x minus x naught into y dash x naught plus x minus x naught whole square by 2 factorial into y double dash of x naught plus x minus x cube whole x minus x naught whole cube by 3 factorial into y triple dash of x naught plus x minus x naught whole power 4 by 4 factorial into y 4 of x naught. Because they have asked us up to a 4th degree terms, therefore we need to differentiate up to 4th degree, that is y 4 dash we have to find out, where the function is given by dy by dx is equal to x square y minus 1. At x is the x naught is equals to 0, our equation, that is y of x expression, will be changed to y of 0 plus x y dash of 0 plus x square by 2 into y double dash of 0 plus x cube by 6 into y triple dash of 0 plus x power 4 by 24 into y 4 of 0. Now y dash of x is given by x square y minus 1. So y dash of 0 will be 0 into 1 minus 1, that gives us minus 1. Next, let us differentiate this y dash of x, which gives us 2xy plus x square y dash. Therefore, y double dash of 0 on substituting x as 0 and y as 1 and y dash as minus 1, we get 0 because x is multiplied for both the terms. Next, y triple dash of x is 2y plus 2x y dash plus x square y double dash plus 2x y dash. Here we are having the two terms, so and each term is having a product of 2, therefore we are getting the 4 terms. Okay, in the 4 terms we are having the second and the fourth term same. Therefore, we can add 2xy dash and 2xy dash, which gives us 4xy dash. And the remaining term is written as it is, that is 2y and x square y double dash. This is y triple dash. Now, y triple dash of 0, if we substitute, the second term will be 0 and the third term will also be 0. So, we will be getting 2 into y, where y is 1, therefore 2, that is y triple dash of 0 will be equals to 2. Now, let us compute what is y fourth derivative of x, which gives us 2y dash plus 4y dash plus 4xy double dash plus 2xy double dash plus x square y triple dash. Here also the like terms will be added, that is first and second term are added, third and fourth term is also added, and the last fifth term is remaining the same. Therefore, we are getting 6y dash plus 6xy double dash plus x square y triple dash. That is y4 of 0 gives us 6 times of minus 1 plus 6 into 0 into 0 plus x value is a 0. So the second term and the third term, which consists of x, will become 0. Only the first term it is equals to minus 6. Now let us substitute these values in y of x, which gives us 1 plus x into y dash, which is minus 1, plus x square by 2 factorial into 0, plus x cube by 3 factorial, which is 6, into y triple dash of 0, which was 2, and x power 4 by 4 factorial, which is 24, into y 4 of 0 will be minus 6, which we have computed. Now, on simplification, we get 1 minus x plus x cube by 3, because this term will be 0, and 2 and 6 cancels, x cube by 3 minus x power 4 by 4, that is 6 4 so 24. So this is the final solution. Now they have asked us to find out what is y of 0.1 and y of 0.2. So we need to substitute x as 0.1 and 0.2. So we respectively get 0.9003 and 0.8023 as the answer. Next, employ the Taylor series method to obtain the approximate value of y at x is equals to 0.2 for the differential equation dy by dx is equal to 2y plus 3e power x, and initial condition is y of 0 is 0. Compare the numerical solution obtained with the exact solution. Given x naught is 0, y naught is also 0, and y dash, which is f of xy, or y dash is equals to 2y plus 3e power x. Now, from the Taylor series, y of x is y of x naught plus x minus x naught, y dash x naught, plus x minus x naught the whole square by 2 factorial y double dash of x naught, plus x minus x naught whole cube by 3 factorial y triple dash of x naught, plus x minus x naught the whole power 4 by 4 factorial into y fourth derivative of x naught. This is the given time. And now, Taylor series, x naught is 0 means wherever x naught is there, it will become 0. So, simplified form will be y of 0 plus x y dash 0 plus x square by 2 into y double dash 0 plus x cube by 6 into y triple dash 0 plus x power 4 by 4 factorial into y fourth derivative of 0. Now let us compute what is y dash of 0 and all that. So y dash of 0 is, y dash of x is given by 2y plus e power 3 e power x, which is given already. Now y dash of 0, let us put x as 0 in this, we get 2 into y is 0 plus 3 into e power 0, that is 3. So we are getting 3. Next, y double dash of x. Y double dash of x is 2y dash plus 3 e power x, which gives us y double dash of 0 is equal to 2 into 3 plus 3 into e power 0 again. And because the derivative of e power x is e power x itself, and so we are getting the answer as 9. Next, y triple dash of x, that is 2y double dash plus 3 e power x. Now this y double dash value was 9, so let us substitute here. So it is 2 into 9 plus 3 e power 0, which is 21. At last, y fourth derivative of x is 2 into y triple dash plus 3 e power x, which gives y fourth derivative of 0 is 2 into 21, which is the previous value, plus 3 into e power 0, which gives us 45. So we need to consider these values. What is that values we have to consider here? See, first of all, we have to consider y dash of 0, which is 3, y double dash of 0, which is 9, y triple dash of 0, which is 21, and y fourth dash of 0, which is 45. So this is very, very important. You need to write on these things and circle it. Okay. because this has to be highlighted, and also these derivatives y dash, y double dash, y triple dash and y fourth dash, all these things has to be highlighted for a Taylor series method. And also this formula has to be written, which for this consists of marks. Okay, one mark will be given for this Taylor series formula, so do remember this. Okay, next, to compute the exact solution, before that x is equals to 0.2, if you put y of 0.2 will be 0.8110, which is the approximate value. In order to find the exact solution, consider the given equation, which is a linear differential equation of the form dy by dx plus py is equal to q. P is minus 2 and q is 3 e power x. So integrating factor will be e power integral of p dx plus, that is minus 2 is the p value, so it will be e to the power of integral of minus 2 dx, which gives e power minus 2x. And the solution is given by y into if integral if q dx plus constant. So we have the integrating factor. This is our integrating factor, e power minus 2x. So let us replace in this step, that is y into e power minus 2x is equal to integral of 3 e power x, which was the q. 3 e power x is q, and if is nothing but e power minus 2x into dx plus constant. Now let me simplify e power x into e power minus 2x. What do we get? E power x and e power minus 2x. So when I multiply e power x and e power minus 2x, what happens? The powers get added when I simplify, because the bases are same, so we are getting the power added, therefore e power minus x. So here we have written e power minus x, and integral of e power minus x is minus e power minus x. 3 is the constant. In order to evaluate the c value, we need to consider the condition as y of 0 is equal to 0. Y of 0 is equals to 0. So when I consider that x is 0, y is 0, substitute, we get y is also 0, so the left hand side is 0, and this 3 into e power 0 will be minus 3, minus 3 into e power minus 0, and c. Therefore, the c value what we are getting is 3. Let me substitute in the equation. We get y e power minus 2x and minus 3 e power minus x plus 3. Okay. Now, the substitution, after substitution, we get this function, that is, this is what we are getting, that is y is equal to minus 3 e power x plus 3 e power 2x. Taking the 3 common, we are getting 3 times of e power 2x minus e power x. Okay, now put x is equals to 0.2 and simplify, we get x, y is equals to 0.8112. This is the exact value, but whatever we have got was a numerical solution. So numerical solution obtained was 0.8110 and exact value is 0.8112. So the difference is 0.0002. So with the exact solution, we find the numerical solution approximates to exact value up to 3 decimal places, because 0.811 and 0.811 is common. So up to 3 decimal places it is approximated. So the next problem, given dy by dx is equal to 1 plus y by x, y is 2 and x is 1. Find approximate value at x is equals to 1.4 by taking the step size of 0.2 by applying the modified Euler's method. Also find the value of 1.2 and 1.4 from the analytical solution of equation. So in the modified Euler's method, as I told you, we have the two formulae. One is Euler's formula, another one is modified Euler's formula. Our Euler's formula is called as a predictor formula, and a modified Euler's formula is a corrector formula. So in the step 1, and we need to compute it by two stages, because we have started with 1, x value is 1. We started with x is equals to 1, and with the step size of 0.2, we have to reach out to 1.4. That means in the first step, if we do, we will be getting y of 1.2. Then one more step if you do, then only we will be getting y of 1.4. Okay. So what has been given here? The function is f of xy, which is 1 plus y by x. X naught is 1 and y naught is 2, which is the initial condition what they have given. This is the value they have given, y is 2 and x is 1. So that's the initial condition. So f of xy is 1 plus y by x. And the stage 1 is x naught is 1, x1 is x naught plus h, which gives y naught is 2 and y x1 is 1.2. Okay. Next. In the initial iteration, modified Euler's formula, y naught plus h, y f of x naught, y naught, if we apply, we are getting 2.6. Next, the modified Euler's formula, which gives us y1 of 1 is y0 plus h by 2 into f of x0 y0 plus f of x1 y1 0, which on simplification we get 2.6167. Next iteration, same formula, only here it will change, that is y1 of 0 will be replaced. So we are getting 2.6181. Next, one more iteration if you do, 2.6182, another iteration 2.6182. Now we can observe iteration 3 and then 4 is same, so we can stop at it. Next, let's go for the second stage. In the second stage, x1 is 1.2, y1 is 2.6182 and x2 is 1.4. Same like the previous stage, y2 of 0, instead of y1 of 0, here it is y2 of 0. So it is computed as 3.2546, and this value is used as y2 of 0 here. So in the modified Euler's formula, it is given by y1 plus h by 2 f of x1 y1 plus f of x2 y2 0, which on simplification we are getting 3.2689. In the second iteration, this value alone it is replaced, so we are getting 3.2699. Again, we are getting 3.2699. That is, second iteration and the third iteration is same. Therefore, we can stop at it. So, x at 1.4 is 3.2699. This is one which we have computed by the numerical method. Now, let us see the analytical method. Okay. So, in the analytical method, as usual, we consider in the standard form, the y terms is taken to the left hand side. To put it in the exact form, like dy by dx plus py is q, with the p is equals to minus 1 by x and q is equals to 1. And integrating factor is e to the power of integral p dx, which is e power minus 1 by x dx integral, or e power minus log x, that gives us x power minus 1, or 1 upon x is the integrating factor. With the q value as 1, let us substitute in the formula. We get 1 into 1 by x plus c as an integral. So, integral of 1 by x is log x plus c. Now, to find out the value of c, substitute the initial condition. X at 1 and y as 2. So, we get c is equals to 2 because log 1 is 0. Next, y by x is equals to log x plus c. So, c value is replaced. So, we are getting this y is equal to. Substitute 1.2 and 1.4 to get respectively 2.6188 and 3.2711. These are the values. This can be compared with the numerical method. Thank you.